Nityanandam, let's start the power manifestation with the Sadguru Vandanam. Let's sit straight, visualize Bhagwan in third eye, and start with the Sadguru Vandanam. Nityanandam Paramasukhadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gaganasadasham Tattvamasyadilakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalam Achalam Sarvade Sakshibhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tannamami. Nityanandam, such a powerful cognition that Bhagwan has given, how we run our life. Whenever we are thinking of impossible, we are in OCD, obsessive, compulsive, and constantly we are driving ourselves literally into chaos and confusion. And this disorder that Bhagwan said, OCD, is how we exist. Now he's beautifully giving us IID, Ishtadevata, inspired decisions. How he said, whenever he gets up in the morning, he knows Paramashiva is going to manifest his day and he's waiting to see what all it unfolds. Such a beautiful space of restful awareness. We'll start the power manifestation with that space when oneness with Bhagwan. Let's go through the important instructions before we start the power manifestation. The important announcement from the security, Kailash security. An important caution, please just go through that and then we'll start the power manifestation. Let's start the power manifestation with understanding what is power manifestation. Power manifestation is nothing but a cognitive shift and can infuse powerfulness into any action or state that we are in. It raises our frequency of the body and the mind to the ultimate powerfulness, Turiyatita. Bhagwan beautifully says how the body and the mind, how we exist and how the raising the frequency will get us into the restful awareness, the heightened intelligence of Turiya and consciousness of Turiyatita. Again and again, doing the manifestation, we understand that life itself is nothing but a manifestation. Living as gods and goddesses, manifesting our reality is how we exist in the space of Turiyatita. Paramashiva, who is Ajomuha, beyond the form and formless, whose Satyojata face, Vamadeva, Agora, Tatpurusha, and Ishana, the five faces doing the Panchakritya of manifestation, sustenance, regeneration, pulling us out of delusion, and liberation. Constantly, the Big Bang and Black Hole is happening in the existential reality. Paramashiva is very much real. He is a living being and he manifests through all of us. Paramashiva has come down as our Guru, Bhagwan, Swamiji. His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Nityananda Paramashivam, is a reviver of Kailasha, the ancient enlightened civilization, the great cosmic borderless Hindu nation. His Divine Holiness, Nityananda Paramashivam, is an avatar from Hinduism and is a supreme pontiff of Hinduism. His Divine Holiness, Nityananda Paramashivam, has made science of power manifestation, yoga, and temple-based university for humanity. Sovereign Order of Kailasha, led by His Divine Holiness, Nityananda Paramashivam, and His Nityananda Order of Monks, Nuns, Hindu Diasporas, are working for the global peace, superconsciousness breakthrough to humanity. His Divine Holiness Nityananda Paramashivam has Nityananda Hindu University, world largest with extended campus in 150 countries, is collecting, organizing, preserving time capsule, decoding, spreading, reviving 20 million source book of Hinduism and the 64 sacred arts And the science like Ayurveda, music, dance, sculpting, astrology, and Vastu. His Divine Holiness Nityananda Paramashivan is 293rd Guru Mahasannidhanam of Shyamala Pita, Sarvanya Pita, apex body, ancient apex body of Hinduism, and present emperor of Suryavamsa Surangi Samrajyam. His Divine Holiness Nityananda Paramashivam has survived the worst prosecution of multi-assassination attempts on person and character by anti-Hindu element. Bhagwan has given the science of power manifestation to the world, which is authentic, time-tested, scientific, and foolproof. The Shastra Pramanas are the eternal, unchangeable truth. And they are from, revealed from the Hindu source scriptures. The Apta Pramanas are the experience or and results of the Aptas, who are the Rishis, Munis, Ganas, or the Siddhas, who are the authority of Hinduism. And they are the scientists who have time-tested and verified the science of power manifestation. The Apta Pramanas are the account of His Divine Holiness Nityananda Paramashivam, this millennium avatar personal experience of power manifestation. The avatars land on planet Earth, play the leela of human being with a human mind, and how ferociously break the boredom and tiredness and experience and expresses the superconsciousness being in the human body. And Bhagavan himself have initiated millions of disciple, devotees and followers into the science of power manifestation. Now let's start with the Shastra Pramana from Veda Agamas. Here, Bhagavan reveals from the Shiva Sutra, Sutra 1.19. Shakti Sandhane Sariro Patihi. Beautifully, he translates by aiming and fixing the self on Shakti, uniting in oneness with the supreme power, the embodiment of that which is cognized and will manifest at once in length, breadth, depth, time and space dimension. Bhagavan beautifully says, even the time and space is matter. If you understand how you can increase the length or the breadth, you can change the time or the space. Bhagavan gives four instructions in this beautiful sutra. Each Shiva Sutra, Bhagavan has elaborately spoken on each of them by aiming and fixing the self on Shakti. How beautifully he has said, whenever we are in delusion, OCD, when you start aligning yourself with IID, the Ishta Devata inspired decision. What is Ishta Devata inspired decision? How we fix the self on Shakti. He gives the example of a child, how he holds the biscuit and does not let the biscuit to touch anything. And simply, when we are very clear about our higher existence, and when we start continuously mapping the higher truth on ourself continuously, doing the abhyasa of living as only Paramashiva, as consciousness, as Swamiji, and again and again only using that as our resources to manifest our life. That is by aiming and fixing the self on Shakti. Deciding on Ishta Devata is your only resource on how you exist, not going by your inner identity or outer identity. He says how it is easy to give up your outer identity, your projection, your reality that you see, your perception reality, and how if you give up your inner identity, so much of anger, violence, frustration, depression, guilt, everything is in the inner identity. When you do the tyaga of the inner identity and replace it only with the space of consciousness as your only source. Again and again, beautifully Bhagavan gives so many examples where we understand how it is so beautiful that how Bhagavan himself lived only by the Ishta Devata as his only source in every step of his life. Uniting in oneness with the supreme power. How we use the currency in this world, Bhagwan uses only the currency of oneness with Paramashiva. Whenever we are aligned to the only surrender, that oneness is the only resources that we are going to experience the higher reality, simply the next dimension starts manifesting through us. He says, continuously, Ajaba Ajaba, remembering Bhagwan and unclutching from this world brings us to the highest resources, which has to be cognized. Those days, Manikavachaka or Arunagirinadar, just by one blessing of the Guru, they were able to experience the oneness and ultimate consciousness. But because of layers and layers of OCD, stuck with the computer, stuck with the Facebook, or stuck with so many things which cannot be happening continuously as our life, when we are to give up that, we need something more stronger to break the OCD. The Ishta Devata inspired decision of continuously chanting the Mahavakya, remembering Bhagwan again and again in your third eye, and constant unclutch from this existential reality that you understand, your perception of this reality that you understand, will unite you in oneness with the supreme power, the embodiment, that which is cognized, that who has cognized, who have understood that this is the most important way to exist, that again and again declaring, repeatedly declaring that IID is the only way I'm going to exist. Bhagwan beautifully says, where do you park when you are in the relaxed mode, when you are at home, when nobody is there? That is the space you are in. If you are stuck with the OCD, you will be restless, stressed, worried, scared, and all kinds of incompletion, which you will be projecting to the outer world. Bhagwan beautifully gives us the IID when we constantly chant the Mahavakya inside, remember Bhagwan again and again in the oneness space, and continuously unclutch that this world, whatever it is, it's not affecting any one bit to the consciousness. Consciousness is a pure awareness, bringing yourself again to the now, the moment, and remembering Bhagwan is the only way. When you cognize as this as your only resources, simply the manifestation at once happens in all dimension. Will she see the Apta Pramana? Ramanujam openly stated that he received the mathematical inspiration and sometimes the whole formula through contacting his goddess Namagiri. While dreaming, he often understood the mathematics and spirituality as one. He felt the zero represent absolute reality, the infinity represented the many manifestation of that reality. An equation for me has no meaning unless it is expressed a thought of God. Ramanujam was the first Indian professor to become the fellow of Cambridge University. He was rated the 100% an ultimate mathematician only because he was just in the IID. He said, my only resources is only IID. If max could be solved by IID, why not in other things that we are going through? Ultimately, he was able to manifest the greatest reality. Even now, nobody could beat him. Bhagwan himself has played the Leela of having a darshan of Devi and the Sri Chakra he drew when he was a very small kid and simply manifested it as reality. Bhagwan has played the Leela to show us a Sri Chakra is not an ordinary diagram for a child to just see a vision and draw it. But Bhagwan simply was able to do the ultimate in reality just because he was in ultimate connection with Devi, Paramashiva, as manifested as Devi. And simply the Achavatara became the reality for him. The Achavatara are living being around us. Whenever we connect to them, they become the resources for our reality. The Shakshi Pramana of millions of disciples who had experienced the power of length. Here we have the disciple who has beautifully said, I decided to practice anyway. Multiple times she did it, but she could not get it. And finally, she said the president, prime minister, head of New Zealand, and simply she was able to get the answer. And when she Googled, she was so astounded, awed, that she got the beautiful answer directly from Bhagwan. She was just celebrating the whole day, experienced the oneness with Bhagwan. Same way, we have another disciple here who has also experienced the length dimension, where she was able to see the picture on a random page and connect to Swamiji through Mahamahakya, and simply she was able to get it absolutely correct. Now, today we will have two rounds. One, the length dimension, where you can write down a question on a new theory, string theory, parallel universe, multiple universe, quantum theory, and let's Google after we finish and get revealed from Google exactly the same answer. All power manifestation has to be authentically done. Otherwise, more self-doubt and more dilution will lead to delusion. The authenticity only proves that you're manifesting powers, not logical things that you're just copywriting from some Google information. So let's get totally integrated to what we are doing. Write a question on a piece of paper and let's sit straight with the head, neck and spine in a straight line so that the Kundalini raises to your Agnya. Remember Bhagwan in your third eye. Again and again, when you remember, remembrance is liberating, Bhagwan beautifully says. Again and again, when you remember the third eye, simply you get liberated. Bhagwan gives many steps for our mind who's very layered into OCD can be just dissolved. Here he says, absolute unclutching to experience the state of Paramashiva, complete completion to experience the space of Paramashiva, oneness to experience the power of Paramashiva. Absolute unclutching is the outer identity that you completely unclutch from your outer identity. Your inner identity completely make it redundant. All your identity is only created by the mind. If you let go the mind for a few minutes, just dissolve it. Simply, it's like an action, Bhagwan says. You can stop it when you desire for it. How you stop it when you're in deep sleep. You can stop your inner identity and outer identity when you make a conscious decision and only experience oneness with Paramashiva. Do the Tyaga that Paramashiva is your only strength, declaring complete integrity with Bhagwan to experience the being of Paramashiva. You becoming the being of Paramashiva, you became the new species that Bhagwan is talking about, not the next gen, but a new gen. Deeply connect to Bhagwan and chant the Mahavakya to raise your frequency. Contemplate on these again and again so that the mind gets dissolved into the space of oneness with Paramashiva. Again and again, we have taught the mind the identity. We are not able to hold ourselves, that we want to let go it and forget it in entertainment or sleep or some addiction. Here, Bhagwan brings us back to who we are, where we can enjoy yourself, the space of Paramashiva, by absolute unclutching from it and being in oneness with Paramashiva, doing the Tyaga that IID is the only resource for you. Simply, you experience the ultimate oneness. Now, we'll have a 10 minutes oneness capsule and we'll chant the Mahavakya. Whatever question you have written, whatever gets revealed, just write down, and at end of the 10 minutes, 11 minutes, we will verify in the Google. Right now, just write the question and let's start chanting the Mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eye. Let the Amrita pour Let the Varni open up, manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the powers in all of us third eyes. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. 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 Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour, let the Varni open up, manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the powers in all of us third eyes. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. 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 Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour, let the Vanni open up, manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of our third eyes. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. 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 Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour, let the Vanni open up, manifest in all of us.
Paramashivoham, 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 Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the powers in all of our third eye. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham.
Please verify what you have got revealed, what Bhagavan has showed you. Whatever it is, just write down and verify with a Google of what question you have posed and what answer you have got. Authentically, Shraddha is the most important in all this, where power manifestation is does not create any self-doubt, but simply surrender to Bhagavan's lotus feet. Again and again, when you start understanding the Ishta Devata can manifest anything and everything, when you hold that oneness space inside you, what is inside, which is the illusion, get projected outside. The OCD can only create the chaos and confusion. When you are very clear, the Ishta Devata consciousness, not your inner identity, not your outer identity, but only your oneness space of Bhagavan manifest as reality. When you hold that space, Bhagavan simply maps the super consciousness, the pure consciousness into your brain and manifest as reality. Now for the second cycle, let's take a book where we have pictures. Don't open the book. Just decide on a page and just start writing the colors or drawing the pictures, whatever you experience from that book. Bhagavan simply will reveal everything. If you are in the oneness space with Bhagavan, all that we perceive is what we are having the Ishtadevata decision even now. But we don't realize that whatever we perceive is because it is part of consciousness. We believe that we can see the laptop. We believe we can walk. So it happens immediately. Same way, you are consciousness. The book is also consciousness. What is in the book is already revealed to you. It's also consciousness. Have the clear will. It has already happened. All you need to do is connect to the oneness space, the deep conscious space, Paramashiva space in you. Again and again, Bhagavan who has come down as our guru, connect to Bhagavan. Remember him in the third eye. Chant the Mahavakya. Simply you will be shocked to see the revelation that happens to you. Again and again, consciousness is your only resource. And other than that, no mind, no decision, no thoughts or imprint or opinion or idea. Nothing is going to come between you and Bhagavan. Make a clear decision and do a tyaga of only Bhagavan is your resource. Again and again, learning the science is power manifestation. So let's start. Sit straight. Remember Bhagavan and start living the space of oneness with Bhagavan and chanting the Mahavakya for another 10 minutes for the second cycle. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Again and again chant.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om शिवम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवम् 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 परमशिवम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवम्
Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Vanni open up. Manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of our third eye.
Om Nityananda Paramashivam. 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 Paramashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. Om Nityananda
Paramashivam. Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eye. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Vanni open up. Manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of us third eye. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. 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 Nityananda Paramashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eye. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Vanni open up. Manifest in all of us.
Nityanandam. If you are part of the Parameshwaroham, go ahead with your poll. Please make sure every time you enter the poll, all the sharing and participating is where you will start seeing life happening. Like how in a game, you participate in life, then only life starts happening. When you are just a spectator, it is not fulfilling you. When you start recording all these beautiful happening and share it with the world, is when we really, our understanding becomes cognition. Going on sharing and causing others reality, the ultimate reality is expansion of our reality, which is a liberation. Please share your experience, your powerful cognition, and whatever you have written and Google, take a picture of that and share it in tinyurl.com/powermanifestation. Sharing all these great truths. This is for the Facebook, YouTube, and Nityananda TV viewers. If you're part of Parameshwaroham program, please update the poll, participate in everything by answering the poll and updating the Facebook. Again and again, when we start sharing, Bhagavan beautifully says, we are pulling ourselves out of delusion. And whenever we cause others reality by power manifestation is when we are getting liberated. When you cause others reality is nothing but your own image of yourself, a part of you getting liberated. Go on sharing as a most important step. It's like you did all this for this to happen. All what we did 40 minutes is only for you to get liberated. So that happens when you start sharing and causing others reality. Causing other reality means bringing them to higher cognition, making them also live as Ishta Devata, as their decision, inspired decision, and making them also liberated from all the OCDs. So giving them the powerful cognition and making them to come for Bhagavan's darshan, satsang, courtyard sessions, and getting them liberated and making them manifest powers, making yourself manifest powers is intense way of doing it. So please share in tinyurl.com/powermanifestation. So now let's surrender all these powerful cognition and power manifestation to Bhagavan's lotus feet. Whenever we manifest powers or when we have a powerful cognition, immediately surrender to Bhagavan's lotus feet, which will raise us again and again to the higher seeking, higher reality. Bhagavan beautifully always says, in the deep seeking and gratitude and space of oneness, simply you can make all your understanding into reality. Request Bhagavan to make all this powerful cognition as your reality. And with that deep gratitude and seeking, let's remember Bhagavan in our third eye and end this session with a Purna Mantra. So let's sit straight, remember Bhagavan, and chant the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Parameshwaroham Padakarpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Thank you, Nityanandam. Thanks for participating. See you in the next satsang and power manifestation session. Nityanandam.